And that team is certainly going to be hard to beat. They won three out of the four races so far as we wait for the start. With all that dust expected, just have a look at the helmet there where they feed filtered air into their special helmets. Now the cars are going to start thick and fast. Harvey and Stone first away in the Castrol Jimco, then the Chepix France Junior and Senior. Senior's driving at the moment. Stanley Illman and Franz Stangl. Listen to that Porsche engine. These are big vehicles, these. The Quick Fit Raceco of Newton Love and Colin Potter's next. And then the Yokohama shot, Mighty Castrol Toyota Land Cruiser, Raneker and Robin Albert. John Weir Smith, Murray Hume in their Raceco. And in comes another mighty machine. This is the Rob Green Land Rover there of Cliff Barker and Malcolm Jabir. And they've been doing so well in this race. That one certainly goes. Here's a vehicle from Mitsubishi Racing that makes winning look very easy. The Repro Gel Pajero of Neil Woolridge and Paul Vermaak. Of course, that's the one they used in the Paris Dakar. We're up front there. We're leaving Tarkastok now on the way to Adelaide. Harvey and Stone are the Pathfinders. Of course, they've got no tracks to follow. And this is where navigation's so important. They've got a Lexus 300 motor in the back of them with an automatic box. They started second. They're still second on the course. The Chepix, they take it easy as always in the early stages, just finding their feet. That very sorted out vehicle hasn't missed a beat all year. Look at that huge wheel travel they've got. And thanks to that suspension, of course, a flat six engine at the back revs along happily at 8,000 RPM. Illman and Stangl, third on the road at the moment, looking for the right line. And these race cars that you see there, very special custom-made machines from the state. A lot of weight on the back wheel so they can get grip, and as you can hear, lots of low-down grunt. That's also a flat six Porsche engine, laced to a Tiptronic gearbox from an Audi. Right, hurrying along, Newton and Love in their Quick Fit race car. Cozy little cockpit, that one. They've got a 2-litre Porsche engine in that. Leaving Tarkastok into the crew-like terrain, here's the Castrol Toyota Raneker and Houghton, and they're flying along. Wait, make one mistake here, and you're in serious trouble. Getting very dusty, still early morning, Woolwich and Vermaak, not easy to see where you're going, and you lose time there, just this dust just hanging. Duplessis in the ex-Variava Scalza, that's a car that's been successful this year, and it flies along, one of the fastest in this race. And what do we have coming at us out of the dust? It's the Krobler and Charlie Warman's new Toyota Hilux from Clarksdorp. They won their class in Sugarbelt 500, and that vehicle really does get along. Sounds crisp as well. Peter Haasbroek and Bosch in the Land Cruiser, Botswana registered Land Cruiser. Fastest in the time trials, can you believe it? Pretty confident doing well. No power steering that one. It absolutely destroys the hands there of Haasbroek, and his shoulders take a tremendous beating. The leader in Class B, who else? The single seat of Tom Smith. He's finished in all four previous races, won most of them. That's in the locally made Mighty Mac. Billy Bond and Graham Newton in the Sandmaster getting on with the job. As they get out of that tough section, we're out into the Karoo now. This is what it looks like at 160 k's an hour. Instruments are pretty basic in this one. All the driver needs really is a rev counter to protect his engine. Into the lead, the Chepix. They've just, it's 120 k's into the course. They say it's rough. It's really rough, although that suspension makes it look like a main road. Normal 4x4 just struggle along here. And here they are, 1 and 2. That's all there is in it. It's the Chepix in front. Harvey and Stone are just behind them. They're just about 20 seconds behind as they come up to the first marshalling control. Bit of paperwork to do. Now Franz Junior's got to get to his work. He's got to navigate. He says go over there to the right-hand side. Which way? Difficult. You can wrong slot so easily. We're in the front. Here we go onto the road. Now you turn left. And we're on our way. Now the pressure's on behind him. So he's got to watch in his mirrors as well. As we watch Cliff Barker and Jabir, at last able to give that, must be the fastest Land Rover in the world, M3 BMW engine, fiberglass body at the back, and it's really flying along. Cliffy's known as Mr. Nice Guy. He's also won his class in the Roof of Africa. Harvey and Stone, the Jimco. Sounds like a slipping clutch, but in fact automatic. Nice way to go off-road racing. Oh, does that sound nice or what? Big power down there as they tear along. Quick Fit Raceco, just fighting for grip. Newton Love is looking for those hard patches to get a grip there. Nicely found out vehicle. Look at all that suspension it's got. The Birkin brothers in their 2.7-litre Toyota Hilux. They used to rally before. They won their class 3 times this year, going very well as Cassie could see in Pete Swanepoel in another Castrol Toyota. And everywhere you look, this Castrol Toyotas. There's the Pajero flying along as well. As the quads wait for the start, we talk to two of the favourites.
Dag, ek voel goed. It's a bit of the verkouerig. Maar in sy vloek, baie goed. Ek sien uit na vandag, sal 'n harde dag wees. It's not a long veteran, it's a short veteran.
Well, judging by the time trial, it's going to be quite a tight race. We don't know if it's going to be like that for the whole loop. But if it is, I think it's going to be quite nice for us. Beautiful to tell, nice hard stuff. So we're going to give it all our best, eh?
And the Dakar legend takes off. Vickers van Diemen in a hurry. He wants to get on the job. Brendan Bardos in the Joburg Yamaha. Of course, he won the Sugar Belt. Champion leader, John Craig Cassell in the Johannesburg Yamaha. And are they racing or what? How they keep this up for so long, I just do not. They stand a little bit, sit a while. Brendan Bardos, once again, he's really getting off the job. Shook everybody by winning the Sugar Belt 400 at Vickers van Diemen. It's like motocross on four wheels. Here he comes. He stands a bit. He sits a bit. He revs that little 350 twin-cylinder Yamaha engine to the limit. Fully kitted 360cc Yamaha. He's flying. These guys are going to be mental racing at these speeds. There's Bardos now. He has it fully open there. Capable 180 k's an hour, as we say. Behind him, the championship leader's done a bit of winning this year too. It's the Johannesburg Yamaha Banshee. They're called Banshee. Good name for them, and that is the John Craig Costello. And some others. This is Paul Chomsa from Natal too. They seem to thrive in this sort of territory. These are difficult machines to ride, but these guys make it look so easy as they race along. A few unnumbered bikes coming through. They're all Yamahas of the L class, basically all Yamahas. And the first of the 200s, another Yamaha. These are the little blasters, 200cc two-stroke single. He's won three races so far. He's had a second place, and he's well in his way to the championship. Addictive Racing Developments Yamaha of Cornell de Villiers. Hello, here's something new. A prototype KTM quad in its first race, being ridden there by Addictive Racing's Dion Belcher. It's 8:45, an hour after the quads have departed. And how do the fastest competitors all think they'll play this race?